Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. Now we are discussing programming in C. So here we are discussing about basic input output functions. The basic input output functions are: input is scanf function and output is printf function. So in this video we are discussing about only introduction and scanf function. In the next video, this is the part 1 video, the part 2 video consists of printf statement. Why? Because we are dealing with the content in depth. So basic input output functions in C language are printf and scanf. Printf and scanf functions are inbuilt library functions in C programming language which are available in C library by default. These functions are declared and related macros are defined in standard input output header file, which is a header file in C language. So now we are moving to scanf function. So in C programming language, scanf function is used to read character, string, numeric data from keyboard. Consider below example program where user enters a character. This value is assigned to the variable ch and then displayed. Then the user enters a string and this value is assigned to the variable str and then displayed. Okay, so scanf, the syntax for taking input is scanf format specifiers address of value 1, address of value 2, so on. Otherwise it returns integer scanf constant character star format variable 1 variable 2. Examples are int a float b, scanf percentage d. Here format specifiers are percentage d for integer, percentage f for float point value. Okay, now format specifiers are percentage c for character, percentage d for signed integer, percentage capital E or small e for scientific notation of float values, percentage f for floating point, percentage g or percentage capital G are similar as percentage e or percentage e float or double, percentage hi signed integers short, percentage hu unsigned integer short, percentage I signed integer, percentage L or percentage LD or percentage LI signed integer long, percentage LF floating point, percentage capital LF also floating point, percentage LU for unsigned integer, percentage LLI, percentage LLD signed integer, percentage LLU unsigned integer, percentage O octal representation of integer, percentage P address of pointer to wide, percentage S string, percentage U unsigned integer, percentage X capital X or percentage small s hexadecimal representation of unsigned integer, percentage N prints nothing, percentage percentage prints percentage character. Some extra uses of scanf. In a past assignment we were required to read strings one at a time without the slash n so that we would print them all on one line. Sequence brackets in scanf allows us to define which characters to read from input. So scanf percentage in square brackets we are writing student at the end as string. In this example the program uses scanf to ask user for a string. Student determines the characters. The program will only take the characters student. So if you input were dent, variable d would become dent, whereas if the input were det, variable d would become det. A is not available in student, so it is ignored. So next example, scanf percentage in the square brackets cap slash n yes string. This example demonstrates part of the aforementioned assignment. Here we have square bracket cap slash n. The not operator is used on the character slash n causes scanf to read everything but the character slash n, which is automatically added when you press enter after entering input. So scanf also allows us to format our input in various ways. We can ignore preceding white spaces or determine the number of integers we would like to read from the user's input. Scanf percentages string. In this example, white space preceding percentages means that any leading white spaces before the string will be ignored. So if the input was student, our variable string would only take student. So scanf percentage is percentage 2d input. In this example, we have a number located between the percentage and d, which in this case is 2. The number determines the number of integers our variable input of integer type will read. So if the input was 3222, our variable would only read 32. Means repeated numbers are ignored. 2 will be 1s. Next, now I am taking example decimal integer int a is equal to 0. Scan of percentage d. It is a format specifier and I am reading one character, that is 45. And now I am printing the value of a. Automatically 45 will be printed. So in the second example, integer may be octal or hexadecimal. So scan of percentage I means octal. Okay, so the input what I am giving is 017. It is converted automatically, it comes to 15. Similarly, percentage d 0fx is converted to 15. So the value of f is 15, the value of 17 is 15. So the second one is floating point type percentage f, percentage e, percentage lf. So percentage f is address of a. I am giving this value. So initially a is, float is 0, and I am assigning new value to them. Automatically it returns 0. So the next is string. I am reading this character, automatically it prints the output. So again, here one character we are reading it and we are printing the value. Thank you.